me, former world champion Johnny Nelson.
Todd, always a pleasure to work with you. Always a pleasure.
Time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, 6'3" tall, the best. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time, fighting out of Louisville, Kentucky. Float like a butterfly and sting like a bee. The Bronze Bomber. Oh, and with that, we...
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing.
No doubt about it, this was the hottest ticket in town by a country mile. Every seat has been sold.
Turn the phone off, close the door, close the curtains. This is it. Leave me alone. Let me enjoy myself right now.
Good luck.
These two fighters promised us an offensive show. Let's see if they deliver. They score that left hand. No rest for the weary. Big shots from both of these fighters. Got to be careful, though. One punch could change everything in this battle. Missed him with that uppercut. Left counter scores. Nice exchanges for both men in this round. Being smart defensively, you love to see that. This fighter told us yesterday, if he doesn't win by knockout, he doesn't consider it a real victory. That's the mentality he has.
How you deal with a slugger, you've got to use brain over brawn. But when a matador pops, jab, move, get them angry.
That punch lands. Neither man really defending themselves. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. You know that bell was sweet music to his ears.
Every second, every minute of this fight is important. Every second, every minute of this...
Here we go for round two. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet, not to the senses of comeback.
Muhammad Ali in trouble, but surely he'll find a way out. Can you believe this? The greatest is down on the canvas.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
So they'll make it up, and this fight continues. Got to find a way to get around that reach advantage.
Very smart, very sharp. This is a fit young man style that he's got to get inside that long reach. Not many fighters can do that.
Both men step back for just a moment. Good left counter that lands. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. And he fails to score with that left hook.
seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. That counter shot lands. Good counter punch. You've got to wonder how big of a factor that knockdown is going to be, we just saw.
You're being put down, you've got to think right, survive, and then give it back the next round.
The bell to start round three. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
If I knock somebody down like that, that round, you know this round coming out? He's getting everything, everything, full barrel, because I know his legs are gone. So this, you watch what's gonna happen. If he doesn't, I'll be very, very surprised.
Not a lot of defense here at all. Division. There's nothing quite like a heavyweight fight. It doesn't take much to win it.
Of course that's right.
The courage on display here is incredible. Seems like he's beginning to recover a little bit. Disaster averted, it seems. We continue on. Counter punching. That's another scoring shot. Beautiful counter shot. Oh, Wilder just got clipped, and he's in a world of trouble. I don't know if I've ever seen him this hurt before. Is this big opportunity? Looks like he's going to survive the round here, but just barely. He's been knocked down, but at least not knocked out yet.
To make or break a fighter.
There we go to the fourth round. He couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
What a knockdown. You know in the corner now, they're saying, when you get out there, jump on him. Do not give him a chance to breathe. Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go, because you know they're on shaky legs. They're a gnat's ear away from getting stopped.
Great counter right hand there. The greatest has been dazed. Muhammad Ali in trouble. He takes a knee, buys time, collects himself.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Exchange punches. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Very close match. He shows this.
If there's anyone that can get out of trouble, it's Muhammad Ali. That right, ladies and gentlemen, a knockout victory and one of the biggest surprises of the year.
A knockout victory? That's not a knockout victory. That is somebody saying, I'm here, I've arrived. Try that again, it will happen all over again.
Score. Look around you. We got a whole room full of money.
Welcome to the WBC Arena. They've been talking the talk. And here comes the Easton Assassin, Larry Holmes. The fighters are ready to...
This bout is scheduled for 12.
So much hype surrounding... The opening bell, round one. Both men step back for just a moment. Can't score with the right hand. He misses with that jab. Open air outdoor stadium. What a venue for this contest.
In such cases, the cornermen need to be able to do their job. Think about what they're doing. One to cool you down, one to ice your back, one to give you instructions in your head, and one to just calm you to tell you what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong. Because that's the most important thing. Forget about the heat. Forget about everything else.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now.
I think they both think we're playing kidney games. This is the fight. When you get in there, you get in the fight. The fans are paying their money to watch you fight. We're sat here to talk about you fight. The cornermen are there because they want to see you fight. We need a fight.
Left counter was perfectly timed. Man really defending themselves. Good punch. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. The game plan does not seem to be working here. What's he have to do differently?
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
Here we go, round two. Who's going to land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
He knows he's being hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart, because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs have gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You find the swarm, you've got to protect everything. The body with the elbows, the head with the forearm. You've got to try and push them off balance, because they will just stay in your face.
Great counter right hand there. That left lands. Nice exchanges from both. Whoa, Larry Holmes! Oh, Larry Holmes is going down, and he's got to get up.
One, two, three, four, five.
At some point, the corner may have to intervene here, because this fighter won't stay down. Output. Thought there would be some more action here. The final 10 seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. And with the right counter. Let's see how the game plan changes after that big knockdown.
Love the response, though. Got back up, took a deep breath, thought, right, brush it off, get on with the job.
Man, he's gone. I'm telling you, he's gone.
On to the third. He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not gonna happen. He's got a hustle now. He's got a block.
And just as quickly as the action slows down, it heats back up. Both men step back for just a moment. Oh, Larry Holmes just got dazed. It appears he's going to take a knee here and try and regroup.
What you're seeing right there is a heartbroken fighter.
Just misses with that jab. Not going to see as much footwork as the smaller weight classes in the heavyweight division, but we don't care. We want the heavy fist.
I've seen it so many times. One punch changes everything. I've seen guys really hands down. They decide to showboat, show off, then blam! It's over. So they've got to stay sharp. One punch changes everything.
In this one. Beautiful counter shot. Well, there was no doubt about who won that round.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter. And the cornerman's got...
There's the bell to start round four. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. A perfect counter shot. This fighter's not showed us much defense at all. This fighter's sort of the death by a thousand paper cuts approach. He'll hit you a thousand times before you can land one.
When you've got a fast fighter, they will cut you to ribbons, and they know it's a matter of time before either you get desperate or the referee jumps in and saves you. This is a natural gift.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. This fighter realizes that defense is one of the scoring criteria in boxing.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dares do anything out of turn.
Good left hand. Nice exchange here from both men. Looks like this fighter did not work on defense this training camp. Counter shot lands. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Well, this is the time that the trainer needs to come in and say something special. This fighter needs into the fray here in round five. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's gonna come out and put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. You gotta be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart, because he's gonna try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
What a gift. What a...
Well, the Easton Assassin in some trouble here. Didn't wait long. And he's going to take a knee. Output. Thought there might be more action here. Nice counter. There's a counter shot. When are we going to see a jab from these two? Neither fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. Seconds to go. Well, we know they've got the advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around? On to the sixth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Seen all the famous boxing movies, the training scenes, the gym work. That's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
And a counter left. And he fails to score with that left hook. With that right hook. Correct me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got... They both want the knockout. Back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why.
That is a show of character. When you're put down, your ego's hurt, your chin's hurt, your body's hurting, and you've got to get up, suck it up, and be right, and back in the game again. It's so, so hard for a fighter.
Both of these men showing exceptional chin, by the way. Congratulations.
Well, there's no argument right there. That you say it. Night, night.
Number one, there ain't room for two.
There ain't no room.
I am the one. Top two, but not number two.
There ain't no room.
Boom. Came in clean, though, without a broom.
There ain't no room.
Still here, still not been moved. I got points to prove.
There ain't no room.
Straight in, more pain, so more gaining. Here it came in, guns blazing.
They've been talking the talk. It's now time to walk the walk. This is the Lighthouse Theater. Eastern assassin Larry Holmes, perhaps one of the most underrated and underappreciated heavyweight. And here comes, and now it's time for.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of.
And this one has all of those big. And that's the opening bell, round one. Both men step back for just a moment. There's a counter shot. It's all offense all the time. Neither man really defending themselves. So much pre-hype surrounding this fight, the fans are on the edge of their seats.
This is not just hype. We are in for something special tonight. What an arena, what an atmosphere, what a build-up.
And he misses with that jab. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. He fails to score with that left hook.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill. Tap for tap. Now, this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you. And so I got to respect both of them. More than happy.
Nice counter shot. Another scoring shot there. Left counter that lands. Nice exchange here from both men. Nice counter shot with the right hand. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on.
Well, we've just taken a big breath, and here we go again. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
Oh, man, you've got swarm in your face. You've got to try and push him off, make him go into the rope. You've got to sometimes fight fire with fire. Hit him low on the blind side of the referee. Get him.
Great counter right hand there. Both men step back for just a moment. Perfect counter shot. When are we going to see a jab from these two? Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. One punch could change everything in this battle.
You got a swarmer on your case. You know you got to fight. You got to hold him. You got to tie him up. You got to lean on him when you come in until the referee makes you break off. But keep your hands high because they will keep punching until that referee says stop.
And it appears they weathered the storm. How? I'm not sure. Which one of these athletes is going to be the first? Oh, Larry Holmes now in some real trouble. Didn't wait. So he will take a knee here and get a nice reprieve from the action. And a round that seemed like eternity for them finally comes to a close.
Needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what, next.
The bell rings and we start the third. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on the end. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Let's see if these two heavyweights decide to exchange bombs early or decide to box a little bit.
A couple of big units here, so I'm expecting power. You're going to have excitement. You're going to have drama, because when these guys slow down, that's when the punches are going to land.
And he just misses with that jab. Just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. Oh, Larry Holmes just, and the heavyweight legend goes to the canvas.
One, two, three, four, five.
Well, they're back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why.
That is a show of character. When you're put down, your ego's hurt, your chin's hurt, your body's hurting. You've got to get up, suck it up, and think, right, I'm back in the game again. It's so, so hard for a fighter.
This is not good strategy. Those punches are doing nothing. Punch score. It looks like he's going to survive the... Well, Larry Holmes now in some real trouble.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
A borderline disastrous round, but he's still on his feet.
They believe they're fighting.
And there's the bell to start round four. They've got to be feeling confident now after what happened last round.
Two knockdowns, and you're coming back from that. That's near on impossible, because your head must be all over the place. Your legs will feel like jelly. What can they tell you in the corner? All they can do is wake you up. They can't even go into game plan.
You hear people talk about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight. Whoa, Larry Holmes on the back foot. And that's exactly where he doesn't need to be. No, we don't see a knockdown. Left counterpunch will score. Nice exchange here from both men. Good counterpunching from both these fighters. Ooh, Larry Holmes just got dazed. Is this big? Nothing else he could do there but take a knee to stop the beating. With that jab. These punches coming from every angle. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. They've got the momentum. They've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
Dominance. Without a doubt, made look so, so easy.
Time for the fifth round. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Yeah, you couldn't write a script like this. This is like...
One, two, three.
many people would have predicted it, but we've got a knockout victory.
A knockout victory? That is, Todd, did you see the shot? That's not a knockout, that's an assassination. What a shot.
Welcome into the WBC Arena. We've been waiting a long time to see these two get it on. Alongside me, English. Here comes the Easton assassin, Larry Holmes, the man that beat Muhammad Ali, but never has really gotten his just due. Criminally underrated. Let's see what he's got in store for us in this one. The bronze bomb. The fighters are in the ring.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner from Eastern Pennsylvania, here is one of boxing's all-time greats, the heavyweight champion of the world, known as the Easton Assassin, introducing Larry Holmes.
A lot of trash talk between these two fighters. Now it's time to put up or shut up.
This is one of those places where if you can fight, if you know you can fight,
high hopes for this battle between these two athletes. Both men step back for just a moment. Neither fighter willing to sit down on these punches. They're arm punches. They're scoring, but they're not going to hurt anybody. And he lands a big right hand. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. We welcome you to this beautiful theater where every seat has been sold, but don't expect these fans to be sitting down. We expect a standing ovation when these two are done.
You walk in, you cannot hide or duck or stand behind anybody. The audience is on you. They see every single movement, every single twitch. If you're scared, the thousands of people out here in this place, they will spot it.
He just misses with that jab. Neither man really defending themselves. Counterpunching. Both of these men showing exceptional chin, by the way. Like this fighter did not work on defense this training camp. Very close round with 10 seconds to go. That was almost a 10-8 round. Complete dominance.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is too easy. If they keep this same kind of pace up, they've got this fight.
To the second round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Good counter punching from both these fighters. You're not going to see a lot of. This is not the way he wanted this fight to start. And they're down, trying to make it up before 10 as the referee continues the count. At some point, the corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down. Counter left hand there. Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. Neither man really defending themselves.
Totally impressed. You know what? You got skill. You got. Oh my goodness. I admire these guys.
Good counterpunching for both these athletes. Keep an eye on this slugger. As you know, he's willing to take three. It looks like we're going to see an early night here. He is rocked. He's going to take a knee here and try and regroup.
What you're seeing right there is a heartbroken fighter.
looking really sharp. Left counterpunch will score. What a huge momentum swing that's going to be, considering that round will be 10-8 after the knockdown. There's the bell to start round three. He couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not going to happen. He's got to hustle now. He's got to bluff them.
That punch lands. Oh, my. The big fella just got rocked. Disaster of... He takes a knee, buys time, collects himself.
5, 6, 7, 8.
He got out of the way of that right hook. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. He threw the hook, didn't land.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Let's see if these two heavyweights decide to exchange bombs early or decide to box a little bit.
Guys that carry so much power, of course they're going to look for that knockout, because it makes a night a little bit shorter. You don't get paid any extra for overtime.
Nice punch. This round could go either way. 10 seconds. This is a high-octane battle. Is down big time on the score.
Wow, you know, I've been in.
Here we go in round four. Who's going to land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
He fails to score with that left hook. Counter right. Exchange here from both men. You've heard the phrase, finding a second win. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
What can they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again, and the fight will be over.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. Just like a match made in heaven.
Going to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots, but that leaves more opportunities for head shots. Good counter punch. Beautiful counter punch. Oh, Larry Holmes just got dazed. He's going to take a knee. It is a TKO win here. No doubt about the outcome.
What's next? A TKO makes it so confusing, because you think, what would have happened if the fight had carried on? These guys are going to have to do it all over again. Because a TKO, to me, it doesn't tell us the full story.
Yeah. ting. No about pain, we bring men right, some body shots fling. Ding ding, step in the ring, does swing left, right, man said get ping. Can't try a ting. No about pain, we bring men right, some body shots fling. Uppercut, fling, right up, fling. Can't try a ting. Send man over the ropes. Man try come for the belt, but I punched you, you never saw. Ended all of your hopes. Now all of your bros are stood on the sideline, head in the hand, your joke of the show. But they keep those hands up, swing for their fences. All your cover, no poorly for sure. How much do you wanna be the champ? How much do you wanna please the fans? How much do you wanna be the king? And how much do you wanna feed your camp? How much do you wanna see people chant? Swing like you, we got a thing to lose. It's the ESPC, beat them neatly. Titles never ever in dispute. Ding ding, step in the ring, I swing left, right, man said get ping. Can't try a ting, no about ping. We bring men right, somebody shall swing. Ding ding, step in the ring, I swing left, right, man said get ping. Can't try a ting, no about ping. We bring men right, somebody shall swing. I came from the Seven Hills, city of steel, home of the village and brilliant meals. Can't take man for a pudding, take man to Ingles. Bobby have a kid on his heels.
Welcome to the WBC Arena, and what an atmosphere we have here tonight. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me, Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Hi to everybody back home.
And now it's time for the tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. And up against him, it's Larry Holmes. Watch out for that reach of 206 centimeters. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. Watch the East in us. And with that, let's...
This bout is scheduled for...
What a pleasure to be in this unique... These two fighters promised us an offensive show. Let's see if they deliver. Both men step back for just a moment. Nice exchange here from both men. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Left counter score. They walked away from each other and then run right back into trouble. One moment changes everything, especially in this division. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. He misses with that jab.
Perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them.
Whoa, Larry Holmes, we wanted action, and they are delivering.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
At some point, the corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down. Jab just got blocked. Final 10 seconds here, and I think he knows who's won this round. Nice counter shot. Boy, this next round is going to be crucial considering the knockdown we just witnessed.
You're being put down, you've got to think right, survive, and then give it back the next round.
And there's the bell to start round two. He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here.
What a knockdown. You know in the corner now, they're saying, when you get out there, jump on him. Do not give him chance to breathe. Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go, because you know they're on shaky leg. They're a gnat's ear away from getting stopped.
Knock a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You got a swarm on your case. You know you got to fight. You got to hold him. You got to tie him up. You got to lean on him when he come in until the referee makes you break off. But keep your hands high, because I will keep punching until that referee said stop.
Score with that left hand. Nice job landing that left counter punch. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. The positives and negatives in the heavyweight division are the same. You can win the fight with one punch, and you can lose the fight in one punch.
Because that's all big, because they can punch, because they've got the weight behind them, they may not be connecting, but trust me, when they connect, that's when this fight sets on fire, because someone's going to get hurt, and someone's going to react.
Good counter right hand again. Nice counter. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. I promise you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you-know-who.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter, and the cornerman's got to put a firecracker on that fighter. Get out there and get the job done.
Let's get it started in round three. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Perfect counter shot. Perfect counter lands. Lands with the right counter. Nice exchange here from both men. They both want a highlight reel knockout. Great counter right hand there. No rest for the weary. There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And don't forget, you can bang too.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Larry Holmes now stumbling backwards. Final 10 seconds here, and this has not been his round for sure. That'll be a 10-8 round for sure with the knockdown.
I love the response, though. Got back up, took a deep breath.
On to the fourth we go. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not gonna happen. He's gotta hustle, man. He's gotta bluff him.
Counter left hand there. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Gets out of the way of that left hand. What is this fighter doing? There's nothing behind these punches. Don't let this fighter's speed fool you, there's some method to the madness. These are precision shots, and they're coming at lightning speed.
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter that's got hand speed and footwork. They're relaxed, they're confident, they know they just have the quick burst, boom! In a split second, they've let four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys are so relaxed, and that's why they can maintain this all the way through a fight.
And the nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap, just like a match made in heaven.
That punch lands. There's a right hand. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. That counterpunch will score. Well, we're entering desperation mode here. Gonna need a knockout.
The bell, sometimes it can be the sweetest sound.
Mix it up, body and head. Be smart, change your angles.
Here we go in round five. Who's gonna land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's being hurt. He's gonna come out and put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. You gotta be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him up, be smart, because he's gonna try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs have gone, he knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Counter left. It's all offense all the time. Ask me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got to get your timing right.
When you have a fight that's got that great footwork and that great hand speed, it's so hard. It's an uphill battle.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Got out of the way of that right hook.
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
Catch and shoot. Larry Holmes now stumbling backwards. Disaster. Nothing else he could do there but take a knee to stop the beating.
Absolutely gassed out. Didn't know what to do and hurt on top of that.
Through the hook, didn't land. This round still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Talk about a one-sided 3 minutes. We just saw it.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolutely...
This is the beginning of round six. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
Todd, we know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
He fails to score with that left hook. You couldn't write a script like this. This is like Rocky versus Apollo. So far, it seems like aggression has been the key. This fighter just not slowing down.
I've seen some aggressive fighters like this, and they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, if you are not fit, that is the worst place to be, having second thoughts in the ring.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
defend themselves. And these shots, even if they land, are going to do no damage. You can tell he's stronger. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Beautiful counter shot. That bell could not have come soon enough for this guy.
Wow, it's like two different leagues.
And that'll do it for the minute break as we get set to get back in the action. There comes round seven. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's being hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him up. Be smart because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are done. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect them, but you've also got to get your shots off. And they forget, you can bang too.
He just misses with that big right hand. Shot. And he misses with that jab. Swinging big and missing big with that hook. Endurance is becoming a factor. You can see this fighter having a hard time getting out of the way of the punches, and they're not throwing as many on their own.
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated, now we're gonna find out.
Beautiful counterpunch. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Eternity for them finally comes to a close.
Every second, every minute of this fight is important. Every second, every minute of this round is important. You cannot afford to lose it.
Jump or see it and he'll ride it out. Go up.
And there's the bell for round eight. Well, they got battered last round. How do they turn their fortunes around?
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot, jab, rest on the jab. Be smart and pop until your legs come back. Then put the pressure on.
Fantastic punch. Hear that old phrase, second wind. You've got to find it somehow.
What can they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again and the fight will be over.
There's a counter shot. Exchanges from both men in this round. swing and a miss with the hook.
So close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
Both men step back for just a moment. It's all offense all the time. Defend yourself at all times, but this fighter hasn't defended themselves at all. Another, you know, the scorecards are going to be all over the. It's bombs. It's not over till it's over, but that knockdown is going to be huge.
Can make or break a fighter.
And there's the bell for round nine. He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not going to happen. He's got a hustle. He's got a breath.
It's onward and upward after another knockout win here.
Accuracy, power, punch, perfect. That must hurt.
I'm Todd Grisham, and there is a buzz in the air here tonight. We're at the Empire Fight Camp. And here comes the Easton Assassin, Larry Holmes, dominated the heavyweight division in the early 80s. Deontay Wilder, Bronze Bomber, one of the hardest punchers in it. And now for the official.
This bout is scheduled for 12.
Lots of hype as they will fight into the night. We're outdoors for this big main event.
You can hear the noise, you can hear the fans. I've been to many, many fights like this, and it's very, very eerie.
And what I say, you must obey. Good luck.
And we're underway in round one. They both want a highlight reel knockout. Hey. won't give us a second to catch our breath. A lot of pre-match drama. Who could forget what we saw yesterday at the weigh-in? Biting at the bit to get it on in this historic venue.
You're getting everything tonight. And you know what? When you're in a theater, you know you've got to perform. There's no cutting corners. There's no making up excuses because you're going to be so transparent or laid out there.
Oh, and he caught him with a stiff jab. Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
He just misses with that big right hand. That counter shot lands. Fantastic punch. Both men step back for just a moment. Both of these men showing very close round with 10 seconds to go. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter, and the cornerman's got to put a firecracker on that fighter. Get up!
And there's the bell for round two. Well, there's no doubt about it. So time to go celebrate after another knockout win here.
Oh, what a shot. What a shot. You see shots like that in the gym. At least for once, this is on TV. Thousands around the world saw that shot. They probably even heard it.
Welcome to the Lighthouse Theater. The time is now as we get set for what should be an incredible matchup. I'm Todd Grisham. Easton assassin Larry Holmes, the man that beat Muhammad Ali but never has really gotten his just due. Criminally underrated. Let's see what he's got in store for us in this one. Deontay Wilder, he is. So now let's go into.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. In the red corner, from Easton, Pennsylvania, here is one of boxing's all-time greats, the heavyweight champion of the world, known as the Easton Assassin.
assassin, introducing Larry Holmes. Fighting out of the blue corner, an Olympic bronze medalist from Tuscaloosa, Alabama, a hard-hitting sensational knockout artist, and a WBC heavyweight champion of the world, the bronze bomber, Deontay Wilder.
All the talking has been done. It's time to start doing the walking.
This is what you'll be talking about for years to...
These athletes have promised us a war. Let's see if they deliver. Score with that left hand. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Nice exchange here from both men. I know boxing fans around the world feel like Christmas morning with these two finally in the ring.
It's so hot, it's so heat, there's a roof on here, you don't understand. When you're working, when the noise is there, the pressure's on, you're thirsty, you're sweating, and you're getting on the wrong side of a beating, this can be hellfire on him.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Both men step back for just a moment.
Todd, we see much, much more, much, much better. We've been spoiled. I'm being unfair. I'm not being unfair saying it's a little boring. It's not boring. We've probably just been spoiled.
Left punch. That one lands. Tell me, this round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
Dominance, without a doubt, made it look so, so easy.
Great work. I love that. That jab's slick.
And there's the bell for round two. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You're going to swarm on your case. You know you've got to fight. You've got to hold him. You've got to tie him up. You're going to lean on him when you come in until the referee makes you break off. But keep your hands high, because I will keep punching until that referee said stop.
With that jam. Larry Holmes now. Down goes Larry Holmes.
One, two, three, four, five, six.
So they'll make it up and this fight continues.
That is a show of character. When you're put down, your ego's hurt, your chin's hurt, your body's hurting, and you've got to get up, suck it up, and think, right, I'm back in the game again. It's so, so hard for a fighter.
Well, keep an eye on this slugger. As you know, he's willing to take three to give one. That's his game plan, and it's worked out pretty well for him so far.
Sluggers will hit anything and everything. Your head, your ear, your elbow, your rib, your belly button. They are an absolute terror.
So final 10 seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. Nice offensive display, landing that left counter. So it's plan B time after being knocked down in that round.
You're being put down. You've got to think right.
Here we go in round three. Who's going to land the first big shot? Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
What a knockdown. You know in the corner now, they're saying, when you get out there, jump on him. Do not give him chance to breathe. Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go because you know they're on shaky leg. They're a Nazi away from getting stopped.
Percentages have to be off the charts. Catch and shoot with the left counter. Good job. Great counter right hand there. Looks like they shake, and he's going to take a knee.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
With that jab. You're not going to see as much footwork as the smaller weight classes in the heavyweight division, but we don't care. We want the heavy fist.
He's got a couple of big units here, so I'm expecting power. You're going to have excitement. You're going to have drama, because when these guys slow down, that's when the punches are going to land.
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. From this moment forward, here we go in round four. Who's going to land the first big shot? Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
Just got clipped and he's in a world of trouble. I don't know if I've ever seen him this hurt before. We'll step back for just a moment.
Come on, give these guys a chance. They're just trying to figure out how they're going to deal with it. Yes.
Well, the Eastern Assassin is in trouble here. And he is forcing him to take a knee.
Absolutely gassed out. Didn't know what to do and hurt on top of that.
Punch. There's a counter shot. He misses with that jab. Lands with the right counter. He gets out of the way of that left hand. As we enter the final 10 seconds here, it's probably a round he'd rather forget. They exchange punches. His legs are gone, but somehow he's still in this fight.
Unbelievable heart, knocked down twice.
Don't let him get back into this fight. It's so important now in his first minute. Yes, I like that round. Good round. You feel good? Good man. Behind your jab and then let your shots go.
Things are starting to heat up now as we enter the fifth. Is this the beginning of the end after two knockdowns last round?
I have no idea what they have left. What? How? How'd you come back from something like that? Knockdown twice? How, where's your head at? Where's your energy levels at? It tells you you've got nothing left.
Okay. gentlemen, with the hand speed that this fighter possesses, how do you deal with it?
When you've got a fast fighter, they will cut you to ribbons, and they know it's a matter of time before either you get desperate or the referee jumps in and saves you. This is a natural gift.
Coming back to life now, starting to land some punches. He threw the hook, didn't land. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I've got to respect both of them, more than happy.
Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter, who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What you do is you fight fire with fire. You either give it them back because that's where they're comfortable, or you play calm, play cool.
Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. Counter shot lands. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Perfect counter land. Well, it's no secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one.
As long as they don't get complacent, you think this is...
Here we go in the sixth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Not a lot of punch output. Thought there would be some more action here. Nice job landing with that right-hand counter. Is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
You've got to be courageous when you're getting in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain then.
Not a lot of punch output. Thought there might be more action here. Parries that right jab away. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type are we seeing so far?
I've seen some aggressive fighters. They can terrorize the life out of you before they've even thrown a shot. The strength they have, the speed they have, and that knockout punch, they want to punch through you. They don't want to punch you. They want to punch straight through you. So you've got to be careful. Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what they want. Because they want to get you there. They want you to stand there, toe-to-toe with them, and have a tear. That's what they do in the gym every single day of the week. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate them as they set their shots. Get out of the way. And they'll get so angry, so frustrated because they can't work.
This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. They've got the momentum. They've got the advantage. How do they carry that into the next round?
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight. Because
here we go. It's round seven. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Nice job slipping the left. Don't let this fighter's speed fool you. There's some method to the madness. These are precision shots, and they're coming at lightning speed. Someone's will cave, but which fighter will it be?
One, two, three, four, five, six.
they'll make it up, and this fight continues.
Well, now it's about getting back to the corner, freshen up, get new instructions given to you, and they've got to gear you up. They've got to tell you what you're doing wrong and what you're doing right.
That's a scoring left hand. Nice counter punch. Well, if this trainer has a pep talk, now's the time to use it, as they were dropped.
He's gone.
And there's the bell for round eight. They've got to be feeling confident now after what happened last round.
Two knockdowns, and you're coming back from that. That's near on impossible, because your head must be all over the place. Your legs will feel like jelly. What can they tell you in the corner? All they can do is wake you up. They can't even go into game plan.
Blocks the hook. He just misses with that big right hand. When you're a power puncher, you're not as concerned with how many punches you throw. It's about how many you land and how hard they are.
It's the one who draws first blood, Todd. That's what you've got to look at. If you hit, and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be on it, but you've got to be confident.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
He blocks the right hook. Good left counter that lands. Then step back for just a moment. And Deontay Wilder just got clipped. Let's see how good he is defensively. And it appears the onslaught is over, at least for now. He blocks that right hook. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. You tell this guy he's got to do something different.
Wow, you know what? I've been in fights like that. When you're thinking, come on, Bowen, ring away, you walk back to the corner like you've just seen the sun.
There's the bell to start round nine. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on you. And that's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
When we talk about a fighter having power, don't just look at the head punches they throw. Look at the body shots. That can be the real difference.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab. It can be intimidating. It just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
That punch lands. Nice job landing that left counter punch. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. She's like a match made in heaven.
Nice exchange here from both men. I want to back out of the pocket here. Look how slow these punches are. Good left hand. Counterpunching for both these athletes. coming back to life. Oh, Wilder just got... It's not over till it's over, but that knockdown is going to be huge.
I love the response, though. Got back up.
There's the bell to start round 10. He couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not going to happen. He's got a hustle now. He's got a...
Big Larry Holmes got locked. It's onward and upward after another knockout win here.
What a build-up. What a journey towards this fight. What a fight itself. The crowd enjoyed it. The fighters enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed it. And what a way to end the fight. There's no mistake there about who won. What a shot.
They could have picked any venue in the world, but they chose this one for a reason. What an atmosphere. Here comes the Easton Assassin. Easton Assassin, Larry Holmes. Perhaps one of the most underrated and underappreciated heavyweight champions of all time. He's got plenty of power and one of the best jabs. And now we toss it.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing.
What a pleasure it is to be here in this environment. What a venue for this showdown.
This is it. This is that.
So here we go. go should be a good one. No rest for the weary. Both men step back for just a moment. They exchange punches. Through the hooks, didn't land. So much pre-match drama before this showdown. Who could forget what we saw yesterday at the weigh-in? These two box. It looks like we're going to see an early night heat. Oh, and that changes everything. And down they go. They're back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why.
Somebody can smell blood. Look at a cool exterior. Look at what they're going to do. Walk him down. Set him up. Don't make them blind him with a jab. Then boom, let it shot in.
Apparently, it's going to take more than that to keep this fighter down. Blocks the uppercut. Left counter scores. Nice exchange here from both men. So final 10 seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. What a huge momentum swing that's going to be, considering that round will be 10-8 after the knockdown.
You've been put down, you've got to think right, survive, and then give it back the next round.
Mate, he's gone. I'm telling you, he's gone. Jump up behind the jab and then let your shots go.
Here we go for round two. He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here.
What a knockdown. You know in the corner now, they're saying, when you get out there, jump on him. Do not give him chance to breathe. Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go, because you know they're on shaky leg. They're a gnat here away from getting stopped.
You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You are fighting the swarm, man. Be smart, be sharp. Concentrate, but you've got to be confident. Do not dance his dance, because that swarmer, once you do that, you're giving a man a chance that shouldn't have one.
He misses with that jab. Beautiful counter shot. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill. Tap for tap. Now, this fight will say, you know what? I'm just that notch above you. And so I've got to respect both of them. More than happy.
Good counter punch. Nice offensive display landing that left counter. Feet here. No, we don't see a knockdown. Good left counter that lands. Thought we were going, and he is forcing him to take a knee.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. As bad as boxing judging can be sometimes, there's no doubt who won that round.
You can't leave it up to the judge.
There's the bell to start round three. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. He got out of the way of that right hook. Better start respecting each other's punching power. That left counter was perfectly timed. use a jab here to establish a boxing presence, but no, they just want to fight. Right when you think the pace will slow down, it picks up. They call it the glory division. There's nothing quite like a heavyweight fight. It doesn't take much to win it.
A couple of big units here, so I'm expecting power. You're gonna have it, Simon. You're gonna have drama, because when these guys slow down, that's when the punches are gonna land.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. She's like a match made in heaven.
Back and forth they go in this round. The momentum continues to shift. Blocks the hook. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. Lucky that hook didn't score. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Oh my, the big fella just got rocked.
Oh, I heard that.
He's going to take a knee here and try and regroup.
That's a really dented the ego. You don't want your opponent to see you do that.
We know they've got the advantage so far, but how does this match get turned around?
Dominance, without a doubt, made it look so, so easy.
Great round, great round. Now, relax, relax. Now, don't wait to load. He's ready to go. He's absolutely shattered. He's hurt. He's ready to go.
Unfortunately, this fighter not going to get more time to heal up and get a breather right back into the action. Back. On to the fourth we go. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Punch, counter punch. Stamina is so important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Not a lot of defense here at all. Just got dazed. He's got a wounded animal right in front of him. Can he put him away? And it appears the onslaught is over, at least for now. Nice exchanges from both men in this round.
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the Jays.
Was off target. Well, he's an assassin.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
So final 10 seconds of the round, and he is looking really sharp. You've got to wonder how big of a factor that knockdown is going to be we just saw.
Can make or break a fighter.
Don't forget the jab, and don't get carried away. Mate, he's gone. I'm telling you, he's gone. Jump up. Body in head, be smart, change your angle, go out there and finish him. He's ready.
referee calling for seconds out. Right back into the action. Things are starting to heat up now as we enter the fifth. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not going to happen. He's got to hustle. He's got to bluff them.
He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here. Well, Larry Holmes now in some real trouble. How did they not go down? They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
Don't get trigger happy, because all of a sudden you're going to be gassing yourself out trying to get that shot, and that's when they catch you.
These two are the perfect dance partners.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dares do anything out of turn.
And he just misses with that jab. Both men step back for just a moment. Catch and shoot with the left counter. Good job. Gotta let your hands go a little bit. It's okay to be aggressive now. A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Good counter right hand again. Well, he is in big trouble here. He may have been saved by the bell.
Needs a knockout without a doubt. Needs to go out there and think, right, you know what? Next round, you're getting it. You're going to get it. Kitchen sink.
He's absolutely knackered, man. He's knackered. He's fine. Don't let him get that confidence. He's going to be stressing about his gas tank now. Keep whacking.
Let's start the sixth. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him. Tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
In the early rounds of a fight, you'll see two boxers feel each other out, test each other's power. And I think this boxer, Larry Holmes, now stumbling backwards.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, you're out.
You saw it here live, a knockout win. Congratulations.
A knockout victory. That is, Todd, did you see the shot? That's not a knockout, that's an assassination. What a shot.
Thank you. welcome to the WBC Arena. Excited to be here for this one. I'm Todd Grisham. Next to me, of Joe. Well, we're all not too many seats. Vinny said this fight would never happen, and yet here it is, and here we go. One moment changes everything, especially in this division. He threw the hook, didn't land. You're not going to see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He wants to bury his forehead in your chest and pound away.
You find the swarmer, you've got to protect everything. The body with the elbows, the head with the forearms. You've got to try and push them off balance because they will just stay in your face.
Another scoring shot there. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. That punch lands.
Perfectly matched. Skill for skill, tap for tap. Now this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I gotta respect both of them, more than happy.
This counter puncher is gonna wait for you to move first, and then we'll strike like a snake. Keep an eye on this guy.
To beat a counterpuncher, you've got to take them out of their pace. Do not wait for them, because if you wait, they'll pepper and pop you all night long. Rush them.
And he fails to score with that left hook. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. I promise you, all three judges here are going to give that round to you-know-who.
As long as they don't get complacent.
Here we go, round two. Who's going to land the first big shot? Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. An uppercut, a big uppercut, and his knees buckled that time. On her right. Let's see if these two heavyweights decide to exchange bombs early or decide to box a little bit.
As that carries so much power, of course they're going to look for that knockout because it makes
the brown bomber in some trouble. Famer Joe Lewis is down.
One, two, three, four, five.
At some point, the corner may have to intervene here because this fighter won't stay down. These men showing exceptional chins, by the way. He blocks that jab. Got out of the way that right hook. As we enter the final 10 seconds here, it's probably a round he'd rather forget. This next round is going to be crucial considering the knockdown we just witnessed. Here we go in round three. Who's going to land the first big shot? He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here.
What a knockdown. You know in the corner now, they're saying, when you get out there, jump on him. Do not give him chance to breathe. Bully him, throw him, push him down, punch him in the back. Keep letting the shots go because you know they're on shaky legs. They're a Nazi away from getting stopped.
Is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. Just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
He misses with that jab. Exchanges from both men in this round. He just misses with that big right hand.
Very close match. It shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything out of turn.
Nice offensive display, landing that left counter. Both men step back for just a moment. Score again with the left hand. Nice counter shot with the right hand. Right hand. This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. After what we saw in that last round, it's pretty obvious who has the advantage here.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they haven't, there's going to be absolute uproar.
Here we go to the fourth round. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
He parries away the left uppercut. Call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
Work the body, frustrate them, take the mind off the chin, take the mind off protecting everything around that. Work the body, use tactics. Sometimes it's all right to actually outbox a fight and beat them on points.
Big shots from both these fighters. Got to be careful though.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. She's like a match made in heaven.
They go in this round. The momentum continues to shift. A big Larry Holmes got. Let's see how the game plan changes after that big knockdown.
Love the response, though.
Time for the fifth round. We couldn't finish him off in the last round. Let's see what this has in store for us.
God, listen to me. I knocked somebody down like that round. You know this round coming out? He's getting everything, full barrel, because I know his legs are gone. So this, you watch what's going to happen. If he doesn't, I'll be very, very surprised.
There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
Todd, you know what? Sometimes when I've got in the ring with fighters like that and you punch them, you just want to run. You want that spaceship to come and lift you out there, because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
Nice exchange here from both men. counter punching from both these fighters. Back and forth they go, neither fighter willing to back down.
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the Jiggers.
And he just missed with that left jab. Nice job landing with that right hand counter. Stamina is so important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It could all come down to who's in better shape.
Now this is about desire. This is about character. This is about want.
Good counter right hand again. Just missed with that hook. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. At this point, you gotta believe he can't win on the scorecards, gonna need a knockout.
You know, I've been in fights like that. When you think, come on, Bo, ring away, you walk back to the corner like you've just seen the sun.
There's the bell to start round six. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's being hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs have gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Nice job landing that left counter punch. Man really defending themselves. When we talk about a fighter having power, don't just look at the head punches they throw, look at the body shots. That can be the real difference.
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you gotta think them. You just gotta be smarter than them. You gotta be like a little faggot and pickpocket them.
Figure out the combination to this safe. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster.
Totally impressed. You know what? You got skill. You got... Oh, my goodness. I admire these guys.
When are we going to see a jab from these two? He just misses with that jab. Trouble.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
That'll be a 10-8 round for sure with the knockout. Bell to start round seven. Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round.
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'll come out fresh as a daisy. That's not gonna happen. He's got a hustle now. He's got a bluffer.
One of the best attributes to have in boxing has nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
What a gift. What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can walk through anything and everything. When you let those shots go and it's just bouncing off and they're walking you down, it's so demoralizing. It absolutely breaks your heart. What else can you do?
Swing and a miss with the right hook. out the combination to this safe. He parries the right jab away. You've heard the phrase, finding a second wind. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it.
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hope to knock them out early? What can they do? They've got to concentrate and relax. Because you know what you can do in the gym, you can do it in a pack. You've got to relax.
You've heard the phrase, finding a second wind. I don't think I need to tell you which one of these fighters needs to find it. This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. Well, there was no doubt about who won that round.
You can't leave it up to the judges.
And there's the bell for round 8. This fight has been very one-sided. What are we going to have in this round?
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything worked. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
Last round, complete domination. Let's see what we have in store for us here. Punch, counterpunch. This fighter has Joe Louis. They're back up on their feet, but I'm not sure why.
It's that forever hope. Remember the fighter, Evander Holyfield? He could be behind on points until the last 10 seconds, but he's fighting like he's going to pull it back. That's the kind of hope we need to see.
Either man really defending themselves. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. It's knockout or bust for both of these fighters. Missed final 10 seconds here, and this has not been his round for sure. He's been knocked down, but at least not knocked out yet.
You've been put down, you've got to think right, survive, and then give it back the next round.
There's the bell to start round 9. He got knocked down in the last round. Let's see what he can do here. There's no doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake.
It's the one who draws first blood, Todd. That's what you've got to look at. If you can't, and you know you're in there with a banger, you've got to be on it, but you've got to be confident.
He misses with that jab. Men step back for just a moment. Energy and endurance are not an issue for this fighter who continues to be aggressive as the rounds wear on.
Sometimes when you have a fight, the best way to beat a fight is not give them what you want. Because they want to take you there. They want you to stand there toe-to-toe with them and have a tear. That's what they do in the gym every single day of the week. What you've got to do is you've got to frustrate them as they set their shots. Get out of the way. And they'll get so angry, so frustrated because they can't work.
Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Shh. fighter doing? There's nothing behind these punches. No power in those punches. He gets out of the way of that left hand. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Well, he is glad to have heard that bell.
Wow, it was like two different leagues.
We've made it to round 10. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get suckered in. Make him fight your fight. Hold him. Tie him up just until your head clears again and your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Right counter. This fighter's certainly not going to out-throw their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
Todd, we know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Nice counter punch. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. And he misses with that jab. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. I think it's safe to say one of these fighters certainly has a significant speed advantage. You can tell who it is.
You gotta ruffle their feathers, Todd. You cannot let them get comfortable. Drag them. Get them complaining to the referee. Because once somebody with excellent foot speed and excellent power gets into the rhythm, the fight is over.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Pretty dominant round there. Let's see how they respond here in the next round.
I seriously hope the judges kept their eye on this fight, because if they...
Here we go in the championship rounds, round 11. Well, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. That punch scores. Good left counter that lands. Just gets out of the way of that right uppercut. Oh, what a punch! We both know who the bigger power puncher is. There's a significant power difference. How would you handle that?
Power. That power might be the do or die.
The Brown Bomber in some... So they'll make it up, and this fight continues.
Somebody can smell blood here. They can smell blood. They've got to be smart. Get in there. Then boom, back in the same spot again. It happened once, and you got away with it. You can do it again.
He missed with that jab. And a counter left. He missed with the jab. Final 10 seconds here, and I think he knows who's won this round. let's see how the game plan changes after that big knockdown.
I love the response, though.
Who thought we would have made it to 12? Let's see how he bounces back here after getting dropped in the last round. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
You've got to be courageous when you get in there with someone that's bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain then.
You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. That jab misses. Both men step back for just a moment. Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Talk about punches and bunches. That's the mantra for this fighter with that exceptional hand speed.
What you've got to do, Toddy, it's anticipation. You've got to wait. You just got to throw caution to the wind and just hope. You're never going to know where the shots are coming from. You just got to put in a guess. When you have a fighter that's got that great footwork and that great hand speed, it's so hard. It's an uphill battle.
Swing and a miss with that left hook. Do you believe this? Both men step back. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. Surprise as we get a unanimous decision there.
Unanimous? You know what? Smart. Smarts, that is. A total change of styles to make sure they got it. Had every round in the bag. There was no argument, no discussion, no mistake. It was so obvious.